is that we're talking about erasing the shame of mental health. B.B. Campbell Moore's International Minority Mental Health Month. And Ms. Zach, what would you like to share with us today about mental health?
Well, my daughter was killed, and her boyfriend shot her through the head. And when she was killed, I wanted to die. Well, I had a nervous breakdown on my feet. However, I didn't know I had a nervous breakdown on my feet. I just knew I couldn't go on. I literally wanted to just lay down and die with her. She was my oldest child. And she rescued me from a sexual abuse childhood history. So she was my rescuer, and when she died, all of that came back. So all I saw was darkness. That's what made me realize that I was having a breakdown. My mental health, and I was depressed all the time. I couldn't get up. I couldn't do anything. All I did was sigh and cry. So that was my mental health issue.
Thank you. And why do you think it's important that we talk about mental health?
It's very important that we talk about mental health because, like right now, I tell my children, when they get sad and I catch them sad too long, I talk to them about mental health. I talk to them about being overly sad. I talk to them about be careful with how you listen to what your friends say. And I tell them to be careful because I don't want them coming home killing themselves or depressed or what's going on with you and I'm not paying attention and I don't know. And mental health for black people trickles down to our children. I never thought I would say that bullying will actually have something to do with depression and mental health, but it's the cause of depression and mental health. And if we don't let our children know that, they're going to be 7, 10, 12 years old in the grave of depression and mental health. My name is Dorothy Butler, and I am stigma free. Hashtag stigma free. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.